Hello and welcome back to Satori Graphics. I'm finally back and I'm here again with another isometric graphic design tutorial within Adobe Illustrator. Now, if you want to check out some of my previous isometric design tutorials, I've got two more on my channel. And I'll link those down in the description box below, which you are seeing on screen now. But today, I've actually got a new technique for actually making isometric designs that I've never shown on this channel before. So stay tuned and let's learn a new technique for isometric design in Adobe Illustrator. So once you've got your document set up in Adobe Illustrator, you essentially want to have a color palette. And one of the easiest and one of the most efficient ways of doing this is coming up to the window and then also the color guide options. Now you have many color schemes to choose from, and as long-term subscribers may know, I really love monochrome. I love monochrome design, so that's what I'm going to go for. But you have to choose your baseline color, so I have red at the moment. And this is Satori Graphics, so we're going to go for purple today. So let's make some isometric designs. Firstly, you need to press M on your keyboard to access the rectangle tool, then hold down shift and click and drag to make a square. Now all of the techniques that are going to be creating the isometric designs are going to be performed in the transform window. So go ahead and open that up from the drop down menu. The first thing we need to edit is to change the height values to 80%. You then need to change the shear value to 30. And finally, you need to rotate by minus 30 degrees. This is going to give you the isometric design of whatever object you've just created. I'm making the base for my design, and we're going to carry on with the tutorial right now. Now I'm simply utilizing my color guide, as you can see at the top here, the monochrome color scheme that I chose, and I want a light source coming from the top. So I'm going to choose the lightest of the purple hues that I have. Now I'm going to make my base 3D, and to do this, I'm going to hold down the Alt or the Option key on the keyboard, and then click and drag whilst holding shift to make sure things stay perfectly in line. For the bottom rectangle, press shift and X to flick it over to a stroke, and we're just going to use this as a guide to perfectly draw in a 3D kind of style for the rectangle. You could use other methods like the blend tool, and there's other ways to do this, but this is just what I'm doing today in today's graphic design tutorial. You then take the pen tool and just simply draw in the relevant shapes that are going to make the rectangle 3D. And once you've done that, you just sample the colors from your color palette that represent a light source. So from the left here, this is going to be in shadow. So I'm going to choose a darker purple for this part of the design. So once you've made the base here, you can group everything together by Command or Control G, but we forgot about the template underneath. And to get rid of that, you can find it in the layers window and then just removing it from there. To scale down your isometric design proportionally, hold down the Alt Option key and Shift at the same time, and then click and drag, and you're going to scale up or down the design in proportion. And of course, you can come back to the color scheme and you can recolor your artwork to any kind of scheme that you desire or you want to use for your designs. This was just a quick way to show you the new method in the transform window on how to make an isometric design. You really can make really interesting, you know, different designs with this technique, but today's video is quite short because I'm sick, as you can probably hear from my voice, and my life has been really crazy and turbulent and traumatic in the last week, so I haven't had time to be making longer videos. But in the future, if you want to see more longer content on isometric design, do let me know, guys, and I will make those videos. Also, I've launched a service where I will actually critique your work professionally, detailed, and thoroughly for a small service, and currently it's on sale. So head over to the link in the description box below if you want to have a service from me where I take a look at your project and offer some really relevant and professional feedback. But yeah, of course guys, until next time, do make sure to have a great day, stay safe, keep well, and design your future today. Peace.